Hi all, Martin again today, and I'm down at the river fishing for Maruta, right? A few people commented on the community post that I made last week with the pictures of them, because they're quite a cool looking fish, and they're, as far as I know, they're only in Japan. This is the Tama River, which is between Tokyo and Kanagawa. And it's probably one of the best Maruta fisheries in the country, actually. So what we'll do, I'll go and see if I can find some. There's a big dam behind me. This river's dammed every 5 kilometres or so. And there's some pools below with riffles. If I don't find any in the pools below, I'm sure I'll find some stacked up below the dam, or at, I hope. So we'll see if I can get some, then I'll come back and talk to you about the gear and all that.
Where are they going? female spawned out. Nice fish. Nice size though.
Oh, that's better. Fight you here.
I like that olive and black pebble going today. Lovely, lovely fish. Seen them in the other post, but look at that, I mean it's gorgeous.
it's up deep, so I thought I'd tell you what I'm using. The setup's very, very simple, right? I've got a 9 foot 6 weight floating line. I've got a 15 foot leader on here that I've tapered down to 10 pound. It's fluorocarbon. I'm fishing two nymphs, right? As far as flies go, any of your sort of trout nymphs will do, really. Make sure they're on good hooks, because the Maruta are pretty strong, especially when they're fresh. Two size 16 perdigons, I've got a butano, or a butano, and a wee sort of yellow olive one with a hot spot, and a collar, and a copper bead, a bit less in your face. The fish have been eating both of them today. But that's it. Nymphs, squirmy wormies. We used to fish eggs at them. And you can catch them on streamers as well. Like glow bugs and streamers work. But the nymphs are the most productive. To be quite honest, the nymphs are the most productive method, full stop. They beat the conventional guys as well. They're spinning. They often fish like a wee MEP spinner or a pala type thing. And we regularly outfish the conventional guys pretty much every time. If you get in amongst the fish, they just eat the nymphs, they eat the nymphs. You know, they'll spook away from the bigger stuff, but they confidently eat the nymphs. Alright, so there you go. When you feel it's time to let go, in your mind. Yeah. Right, well, that's me. I'm packed up, I'm going home. The fishing's been good today. Once I get in amongst numbers of fish, they become kind of competitive when they're together. As you'll see, it's dead simple fishing. In the pools and the riffles, I just swing the flies where they're stacked up in numbers and I can get behind them or parallel them. I'll usually use just like old fashioned high sticking or like check nymphing, old school check nymphing. It's not the most technical of fishing. I don't know how many I caught, maybe 25, something like that. There's loads anyway. I didn't film all the fish that I caught because that would have been nuts. But I stuck it out longer than I normally would on the Maruta. Normally I would catch half a dozen or 10 and then just go and try to look for carp or something. But because I was trying to make the video, that was fine. Bit of a sour note at the end there. I've lost a box of nymphs. A C&F box, a large C&F box with a swing leaf that was pretty much full. So I don't know how many flies that is. It must be about 400 or 500. I retraced my steps, couldn't find them. Wasted a good hour. Maybe somebody's picked it up or it's come out, you know, it's fell out of a pocket or something in the water. That's a bit of a bugger. I'll have to tie a new box of nymphs now. But fine. Nothing I can do about it now, so we'll just need to get tying. But anyway, I hope that gives you a kind of insight into the fishing. It's dead simple, you know. In the pools and the riffles, I tend to like just crossing down and let the nymphs. Oh, this, you can fish a streamer. Obviously, you can let that swing as well. But if I find the fish piled up, which you'll see in the video, it's sort of old school high sticking and or old fashioned check nymphing tends to work well. You could use a Euro rod and a mono rig, but I prefer to have the 6-weight so that I can switch if I fancy going after some smallmouth bass or something. Versatility of the Euro rod's just no there, you know. But anyway. Hope you enjoyed the video. And I'll see you on another one. Cheers, guys. Bye.